Welcome to the GSA Kahoot e-learning series. In this video, we will introduce you to the Sustainability app. The Sustainability app can be used to track and document the sustainability scope, goals, compliance, narrative, and guiding principles that are applicable to a project. Let's log into Kahoot so we can learn more about this app. Look at the project title listed in the top bar. If you need to open a different project, use the project finder in the left navigation. Click the app launcher and open the Sustainability app. Click New to create the record. Under the Building Info tab, select the appropriate building. Notice the drop-down list will only show buildings listed in the project details. Each sustainability record will apply to only one building, even if there are multiple buildings in the project. Once a building has been selected, click Save. Six tabs will appear across the top of the form. The Building Info tab displays the building's information from Rexis that may also be found in the project details. If changes need to be made to the details section, please contact the project manager. The Administration section is editable only by the GSA Sustainability admins and domain administrators. To add additional documents to the References section under the Building Info tab, click Upload to upload a document from your computer, or add a Kahoot doc to add a document already saved to your project. The Scope tab enables GSA to efficiently track, analyze, and report sustainable building features. Click Add Scope Item in the Scope Items section. Check the box in the far left column beside each scope item to be included in the project's sustainability scope. Click Select. Click the flyout icon beside the scope item. Enter the applicable details in the Scope Elements, Features, or Types section. Use the Next and Previous buttons at the top right-hand side of the window to move through the list of scope items. Click Done in the bottom left corner to close the window. Click Save and Close. This will take the form out of edit mode, and you will now have the option to approve each scope item. You will be required to select the Ready for Reporting or Not Ready. Ready for Reporting includes the item in the fact sheet report, marks the item approved in this scope item list, and also in the Approvals tab. Not ready leaves the status as logged but starts tracking the item and comments in the Approvals tab. Each scope item may also be descoped and rescoped as well. The Goals tab gathers your project's key design performance targets and goals. You may track waste management, performance projections, LEED, sites, Green Globes, Energy Star, and wellness. To add information to each section, make sure you are in Edit mode under the Goals tab by clicking Edit in the top toolbar. In the Waste Management section, you can enter the amount of diverted waste and total waste to calculate the waste diversion percentage rate and enter in any additional information. Please refer to the Sustainability Quick Reference Guide for more information on unit conversion. In the Performance Projection section, you select if the project is anticipated to measurably affect the building's energy performance and fill out additional information. In addition, by entering values in the baseline grid, you can calculate the read-only change percentage row, total energy column, and the EUI column. Please refer to the Sustainability Quick Reference Guide for more information on conversion amounts. In LEED, Sites, Green Globes, and Energy Star sections, enter the information as applicable for each certification. In the Wellness section, check the boxes as applicable if pursuing additional certifications or safety ratings and enter in any additional health and wellness comments. In the Goals Approval section, you can update the goals status from logged to approved for reporting or not approved for reporting. Click Save to save the changes made, and the new status will appear under the Approvals tab. The Compliance tab applies to all new construction and major modernization projects. These project types must meet the guiding principles for sustainability federal buildings. Click on the More Details flyout button next to a criteria item. Select a comment type from the drop-down list and then select the status and enter any comments as necessary. Use the Previous and Next button to move through each criteria item. Click Done and then Save. If you click on the flyout beside the LEED criteria item again, you will notice the latest comment appears in the most recent section and the item's history section. Updated comments will override the latest comment, and the item history will show all comments. The Narrative tab collects information on high-impact areas of design intent. To add information for the narratives and stories, make sure you are in edit mode by clicking Edit in the top toolbar. Check the applicable boxes and enter in narratives and stories for your project. You can copy and paste from another document by using the Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V function. Click Save and Close to save your changes. The Approvals tab tracks the status history of scope items and goals. No edits are made in this tab, but users can use the Sort and Filter option in each column to sort through data. Once a sustainability record has been created, users can print, save, or download project sustainability fact sheets. Click on the Reports icon located under the project name, and then select the sustainability fact sheet. Click View at the bottom of the screen. When the fact sheet appears, use the Kahoot! Report functions to print, save, or download the report. This concludes the introduction to the Sustainability Application e-learning video. For additional training materials, make sure to check out the Kahoot! Sustainability Quick Reference Guide. Thank you for attending. If you need assistance with Kahoot!, please reach out to kahootsupport@gsa.gov.